YouTube audio play very big role on your channel success. If your audio is hard to understand or consume lots of noise or echo, your video viewers will leave the video earlier than they should have. Despite having great effort while making video, I struggle a lot with my audio recording and editing for my first few YouTube videos. In this video, I will show you how I record and edit audio at home using DaVinci Resolve. If you also make a YouTube video from home, this video is for you. The microphone I'm using for the recording is Yeti Blue, but you can even record with your any kind of headphone. So in the Yeti Blue microphone, I have a setting gain set to 0. And in the pattern, I have one with a heart sign, which pick the audio from the front and avoid the noise from the backside. Remember, you can record audio using Yeti Blue with many other applications, as such Voice Memo for the Mac, Voice Meter Banana for the Windows, but DaVinci Resolve recording is one of the best I found by far. So how I record in DaVinci Resolve? Let's connect audio recording device with my computer. In this demo, Yeti Blue USB cable is connected to my computer. Let's open the DaVinci Resolve and see the setting. I'm going to create a new project called Demo. When you create a new project, you land into cut window. We need to walk into the edit window. So let's go to edit window. Since I don't have any object in the edit window, DaVinci Resolve don't allow me to patch the recording device. Let's put some basic text title in the timeline. So as you can see, these objects open the audio and video session in the timeline. Since we have audio and video session enabled now, let's head to the far lights, the little music icon, and set up the audio recording device in DaVinci Resolve. On the far right window, if you don't see the mixer on the right pane, just click to the mixer icon located on the right menu bar on the top. On the mixer, click to input section where it shows no input right now and choose the input. As you can see, the Yeti Blue as a source. If you land into the elsewhere, please choose audio input from the drop-down. The audio source 1 and 2 correspond to the audio right and left hearing. For this demo, I'm going to choose both 1 and 2, Yeti Stereo, and click to the patch. As you can see, the input session of the mixer, Yeti Stereo, is listed. Let's look at the audio timeline. You can see the R square button. If you click this, your DaVinci Resolve is ready to record your audio. To record the audio, you just have to click on the record icon located to the top next to the play and stop icon. If you like by far, please consider subscribing to my YouTube channel. Before starting with the recording, if you are new to audio recording in DaVinci Resolve, let's fix this 4 important setting. While recording, put your Yeti microphone device approximately 10 to 15 centimeter away from my mouth. If you do not have a pop filter in your microphone, cover your mic with some clothes. I always put my winter cap over the microphone. Trust me, it makes difference. Put an earphone or headphone in your computer or laptop audio input. This helps avoid echo in your audio while recording. While recording the audio, make sure your voice level is between -10 to -15 dB. It will show the yellow bar in the audio session of the mixer. Personally, this happened with me. I'm a very shy guy and I struggle a lot. I used to have unnecessary pause or some high and low voice while recording. It is still the case sometimes, but now If I feel the audio I'm recording is too fast or too slow or too many pauses, I simply record the same line again. Having an additional recording is always a good option. Once you have done with the recording, you can check your audio quality. Almost 90% better than all the other recording software you used before. Now, let's make it 100% correct with some EQ setting. This is where you need to understand your own voice. Click into EQ located on the same pan as input in the mixer. Now, let's enable the band 1 and band 6 as well. The basic setting, band 1 is frequency around 60 to 110 based on how high you maintain your dB while recording. For the band 6, from 6K to 10K goes better. In this video, I'm going to edit based on my own voice. I believe every voice have a different high and low, but if you understand the concept here, you will understand what you need to fix in your audio. While editing, make sure audio playing in the background with the loop selected. In the audio equalizer, for the band 1 and band 6, use the same matrix as described above. I'm recording this audio in my room, so for the band 2, not so much I need to do, but I want band 2 align after the band 1 and similar frequency to match the audio level. In the band 3, I'm going to make a gain plus 20 and Q factor to 10.3. Now I'm going to find the unusual sound by moving the frequency.
Demo audio recording using DaVinci Resolve.
There I found something like broken tape kind of voice. Let's do similar finding on the band 4 as well. Okay, I found another crack of voice in the audio. Now I'm going to lower the gain of this band 3 and 4 to approximately minus 10. I suggest you to have a headphone while moving the audio gain to plus and minus. Minus 10 fits good on my voice. Your could be different from minus 8, minus 5 or minus 11. Now on the band 5, I'm going to align with the band 6 and move a bit. So let's add some audio effect to polish the voice. In the effect section, if you click in this plus icon, I'm going to use the noise reduction, the first one. Since I'm on male, I'm going to use the male assets and going to choose this range, this particular range, mostly pointing. You can also listen if there is a noise. The another one I'm going to add is also from the noise reduction. Because I have a lot of pause and while talking, and probably it's going to distract while listening. So now I can even choose to remove what frequencies should I have it on. I'll choose in the 60s, and this is also going to help my audio better. You can choose to have some more audio setting. For example, I think this dialogue processor is also very useful. I used to have it back in days, but it's not mandatory. If you don't like the effect you use, you can just simply click on this arrow icon and remove it. So we already choose a basic setting. I think my audio is way better now. So let's find out how I edit my audio in DaVinci Resolve. For the editing the audio in DaVinci Resolve, let's head to the edit window. Like I explained earlier in this video, if I feel like the audio I'm recording is not clear, or I'm speaking too fast or too slow, or some noise just pop up while recording, I take the multiple recording. Now, with the help of this blade, I'm going to trim or cut my audio and remove the part does not need for my video. The best part of having a recording device connected to DaVinci Resolve is if I find my sentence is not finished or if I just want to add some additional voice in my audio, I can place the recording exact place in the audio timeline and head toward the far right and start recording the additional audio right away. This is super easy way I found while recording the audio. No need to export, import or anything, since all the audio settings such as equalizer, EQ or noise remover are located in the audio one timeline, I don't even need to edit anything additional. My audio is ready to go. For the final touch, let's add a background music in this audio. For the background music, first I normalize the music by minus 20. The background audio can still be loud and your viewer can find difficulties while listening to your video. I'm going to zoom this audio timeline. You can see the background audio have a line in the middle. If I hover my mouse, I can move the wave up and down. I want the background music to be low level, so I make the wave small. I would like to adjust some background music smoothly ending or starting while playing the video. So by doing this method, you can also make the smoothly starting or ending of your background music while playing the video. I hope you understand how to set up a YouTube audio recording studio at home. If you think this video is helpful, please consider subscribing to my channel. Until then, take care and see you.